Hey, welcome guys to another edition of Get Rice Now, Law Edition. Smoking a great cigar. This is a good friend of mine, Bruce Smith, gave it to me. Anybody that knows me knows I like to smoke cigars. So the thing that we're going to talk about today is the January 1st, 2023, the gun carrying law, more specifically in the state of Alabama. A couple of points I want to bring out. I'm not for or against it, okay? So I need you to completely understand that I'm not for or against it. Essentially, all I'm saying is give me the facts. And the facts are this. The guys who are prohibited for carrying, concealed carry guns are still prohibited from carrying. We got a lot of pushback, I know, from the Sheriff's Association here in Alabama. And I'm not in law enforcement. I have handled criminal cases before, and I haven't looked at the data to really tell. But here's the big thing. The big thing is you no longer are going to be required to do a background check in the state of Alabama to get to conceal and carry. I know one of the biggest things is that if you're a felon, you cannot have any type of gun around. You can't carry. So let's explore this a little bit. What's the whole purpose of carrying guns? Okay, so when our forefathers, you know, drafted the Declaration of Independence, one of the amendments, which is the Second Amendment, is the right to keep and bear arms. And one of the purposes of this was to, you know, one, give individual rights to citizens to protect not only themselves, their family, their loved ones, their homes, their space. And we look at the totality of that, the basis of that amendment, it does make sense, right? Because let's say if you have a burglary, or you have somebody trying to rob you or something like that, you can call 911, but it's only so much of response time that you can get from 911. And you know, I think, me personally, and you got that, you need to have some form of protection. One form of protection, which I've learned when I was doing martial arts, is to, you know, don't put yourself in situations, okay? Don't put yourself in situations where it seems kind of iffy, like neighborhoods or the crowd of people, or not just doing anything illegal like drugs or anything like that. Another thing that I will say in regards to the totality of this is, hey, how does this affect you? Don't just kind of go and be all willy-nilly and just doing anything and everything that you want to do because you feel like you can carry, conceal carry. When you get pulled over by a police officer, make sure you abide by the police officer. Let them know that you're carrying. Don't you know, brandish your weapon, showing your weapon out. Don't just fire shots, even though I know a lot of people was firing shots in, you know, in their neighborhood. And I think the overall consensus is be safe. I think we all, for majority part, outside of, you know, I guess kingpins and crime syndicates, I guess, we all want a safe neighborhood. You know, we all want a neighborhood where, you know, we can, our kids can play outside, play with one another. We all want to be able to go to a store, shop, don't have to worry about somebody stealing or robbing. Want to, you know, just enjoy the fruits of our labor. So I know all this sounds kind of off topic, but really, when you start talking about this new law, it's very, very important to understand that, hey, is a reason for this amendment, but taking out of context does not help anybody. Once again, I'm not for or against any particular on either side of the law. I am for protecting myself and protecting my family. So just a historical note, in Alabama, the sheriffs, in order to get a concealed license, a permit to carry, you had to go to the sheriff and do a background check. And that basically was simply saying that, hey, if you did X, Y, and Z, you were not allowed to carry. And which, It's kind of the general principle now. I would love to look at the data. I'm going to probably do another video probably later on this year, just kind of see what the numbers are. You know, did it help, did it hinder? A lot of the crimes I know from when I work criminal cases, it's been done with illegal weapons anyway. So I will assume that there's probably just gonna be another charge laid up on anybody who conduct any type of illegal act or some felony of sorts. So all I'm saying, all in all, I believe in protecting yourself, but also you gotta know your rights. I think one of the biggest things that you see in the community is that a lot of people don't know the exact laws and don't know how to protect themselves. So the biggest thing is learn to protect yourself, learn what to do and what not to do. Even if you do have a permit to carry, I'm gonna carry mine just to be on the safe side. Not sure the law is gonna change back, maybe, maybe not. But all in all, make sure you take care of yourself and make sure you know the law. You guys have a blessed day.